purpose is how I can raise up ordinary men, turning them to become supernatural beings, financial apostles, making life better, bringing people from the dungeon of sin, bringing them into the faith, planting their feet, and rising them.
What he knows! What he knows!
Are you blessed? Somebody shout a bigger amen. Nehemiah chapter 6 verse 1 through 19. It came to pass when Sambalat and Tobiah and Geshem the Arabian and the rest of our enemies heard that I had built the wall and that there was no breach left therein, though at that time had not set up the doors upon the gates. The Sambalat and the Geshem sent unto me, saying, come, let us meet together in some one of the villages in the plain of Ono. But they thought to do me mischief. And I sent messengers unto them, saying, I am doing a great work so that I cannot come down. Why should the work cease? Will I leave it and come down to you? Yet they sent unto me four times after this sort, and I answered them after the same manner. Then sent Sambalat his servant unto me in like manner the fifth time with an open letter in his hand, wherein was written, it is reported among the heathen, and Gashmu said it, that thou and the Jews think to rebel, for which cause thou buildest the wall, that thou mayest be their king according to these words. And thou hast also appointed prophets to preach of thee at Jerusalem, saying, there is a king in Judah, and now shall it be reported to the king according to these words. Come now, therefore, and let us take counsel together. Then I sent unto him, saying, there are no such things done as thou seest, but thou findest them out of thy own heart. For they all made us afraid, saying, their hands shall be wicked from the work, that it may not be done. Now therefore, O God, strengthen my hands. And afterward, I came unto the house of Shemaiah, the son of Deliah, the son of Metalbel, who was shut up. And he said, let us meet together in the house of God within the temple, and let us shut the doors of the temple, for they will come to slay thee. Yea, in the night will they come to slay thee. And I said, should such a man as I flee? Who is there that being as I am, would go into the temple to save his life? I will not go in. And lo, I perceive that God had not sent him, but that he pronounced his prophecy against me, for Tobiah Sambalat had hired him. Therefore was he hired, that I should be afraid and do so, and sin, that they might have matter for an evil report, that they might reproach me. My God, think thou upon Tobiah Sambalat according to these their works, and on the prophetess Nahodiah and the rest of the prophets that would have put me in fear. So the wall was finished in the 25th day of the month Elul, in the 5th and 2 days. And it came to pass that when all our enemies heard thereof, and all the heathen that were about us saw these things, they were much cast down in their own eyes, for they perceived that this work was wrought of our God. Moreover, in these days, the nobles of Judah sent many letters unto Tobiah, and the letters of Tobiah came unto them. For there were many Judah sworn unto him, because he was the son of the law of Shekinah, and the son of Hara, the son of Johanna, had taking the daughter of Meshulam, the son of Berukiah. Also they reported his good deeds before me and uttered my words to him. And Tobias sent letters to put me in fear. Joel chapter 1 verse 4. That which the palmer worm had left had the locust eaten, and that which the locust had left had the canker worm eaten, and that which the canker worm had left had the caterpillar eaten. Matthew 16 verse 13. When Jesus came into the coasts of Gerasa the Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? And they said, some say, thou art John the Baptist, come Elias, and others Jeremias, and one of the prophets. Said unto them, but whom say ye that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Verse 17, let's see his reply. And Jesus answered him and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood had not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say unto thee that thou art Peter, upon this rock will I build my church, and the gate of hell, and the gates of what? Hell shall not prevail. Let's read it all together. And I say unto thee, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. Say it one more time. Shall I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. We have a lot to say today, then I will lay a foundation today, because this is a long topic and I don't think we can exhaust that today. It's something we've dealt with several years ago, but we could not finish it because of the extensiveness of this topic. I want to share with us on the caterpillar and pillar in the church. The caterpillar and pillar in the church. The caterpillar and pillar, not of the church, but in the church. The caterpillar and pillar in the church. The caterpillar and pillars in the church. Now, when the last scripture we read there in the book of Matthew, Jesus was saying, asking the disciples, who do men say I am? Some of them said, you are Elias. Some said, you say you are Jeremiah. Some said, they said, you are the prophet. And Jesus said, that's not what I'm asking. Now, I want to know your own opinion. I understand that that's their view. Some said you are Elias. Some said you are Jeremiah. Some said you are the prophet to come. I want to know your own view. So there come a time where a leader begin to sample the opinion of the people that are around him. Because Jesus was getting not comfortable, because at this time there were so many rumors about Jesus' ministry, and there were so many misconceptions, misinterpretations, and a lot of critics that was going on in the atmosphere. And Jesus wanted to use a spiritometer to measure the standard of their understanding about his personality. And you must understand that I have told you the tiny line between integrity and reputation. That your reputation is what people say about you, but your integrity is what God says about you. And now Jesus was not interested in his reputation, because his reputation was the view of men. He was interested in what they understood about what God thinks about him. And were they able to decode? Because some were saying that he was Elias. Now, that's not bad. To call him Elias was calling him one of the prophets. Some said you are Jeremiah. That's not bad. Jeremiah was one of the major prophets. That's not bad. And some said you are a prophet. That's not bad. They were trying to say, they say you are. But Jesus was saying that, I don't want to have failure in this network. I don't want to have a near success syndrome. I don't want to have a trial by error. Conclusion. I want you to know who I am. So who do you think I am? And Peter said, I know who you are. You are the Christ. You are the Messiah that was prophesied, that was to come. And you are the Son of the living God. I might be close to you. I might lie down on your lap. I might sit down close to you. But I know you are the Messiah. The familiarity of Peter did not make Peter's eyes to be blindfolded to the reality about the capacity that Jesus carried. And Jesus said to him that, yes, flesh and blood have not revealed this to you. He said, now, upon this rock, who is the rock? Jesus is the rock. Shall I build my church? And the gate of hell shall not prevail. Who will build this church? Who will build this church? I did not hear you well. Who will build this church? Who is the owner of the church? Jesus. Who will build the church? Jesus. Who is the owner of the church? Jesus. No pastor can build a church. Anytime a man of God is forcing himself to grow the church, he lacks spiritual understanding. The growth of the church is spiritual. The church growth is a spiritual thing. The church is a spiritual entity. And the approach to grow the church must be spiritual. Thank God for home cell meeting. Thank God for evangelism group. But hear this, if God does not say amen, it will be a corporal punishment. So God said, I will build. So, I remembered in Songwater, we had a program where we were opening our church, and I distributed flyers all over Songwater. Go everywhere, distribute, went. I used about 1 month preparing for that program. Went door to door, inviting people, come to church. Come, we are starting the church. I told them, advertise it. I still have the first poster, first flyer ever printed. You will not see my face because it's black and white. Very black and white. Now I distributed. I was very convinced on the day of the program that the crowd will be everywhere. I was so convinced. Now we arranged chairs. Went and arranged chairs everywhere. We went and rent musical instrument. I know the kind of musical instrument that we used to do. It's those Owambe musical instrument. Owambe. You know those kind of musical instrument that when they blew the square, boom, boom, boom. Those are the musical instruments. I went and rent it. Now we are now waiting for people to come. People did not come. Waited. I invited Exodo Drama Ministry in the whole, they were there in Songwater. They came to act. They were about six of them in the drama, I think joining me and my son, and then one other woman that came, that was all. Then that means that we had one convert that came. And the woman that came, the child was crying. As the child was crying, she was busy patrolling. When she wanted to go, my son said, don't go, wait. Then I became depressed when I got back home. I said, God, why? And the Lord said to me, son, when it is time for me to build my church, I will build my church. I am going to build. Your effort can't build my church. When I hear pastors fighting over members, they don't have the understanding. I will build my church. I will build. When I hear members threatening pastors with their attendance, I'm leaving this church. When I leave, let me see how the church will grow. You lack understanding. I am going to build my church. Nobody, Gila, can build the church. I have heard pastors talk about big men in their church. I say it's a myopic and pindomic and microscopic mentality. The church cannot be built by the number of personality you have. You can have presidents of countries in your church. That does not mean that the church will grow. I will build my church. God is the one that builds his church. He does not build his church on the name of personality. He does not build his church on the caliber of people that come to church. He does not build his church on the amount of congregation you have. I will build my church. I am the one that will build the church. You are not the one. It is not the evangelism school, the home care fellowship system, the house fellowship system. I thank God for that. I'm not against all this numerous church growth procedure, but the spiritual word for it. Let's leave that scripture there. He said, I will build my church. And he said, and I say also unto thee, thou Peter, upon the rock, I will build my church. I will build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail. Upon what? The rock. And who is the rock? Christ. The church cannot be built on the elders of the church. The church cannot be built on the general overseer. So when the general overseer is gone, the rock is still there. The Bible call him the eternal rock of ages. The rock, I will build my church on the rock, not on the personality, not on the senators and the governors that attend your church. Your church cannot be built on personality. It is built on the rock. I will build my church upon where? The rock. I will build my church upon the rock, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. If the church is built on rich members, the gates of hell will prevail. If the church is built on the name of the general overseer, the gates of hell will prevail. And that's why when the church is built on the rock, even when the Messiah was out of the scene, even when he was taken down to heaven, the evangelism continued. We saw what Peter did on the day of Pentecost after being baptized in the Holy Ghost, because the church was not built on Peter. It was not built on Andrew. It was built on the rock. And who is the rock? The eternal rock of ages. Tell anybody, I am built on the rock. Say it where? I'm built on the rock. I didn't hear you well. Say, I'm built on the rock. Shout it like thunder. Say it well. So, don't ever threaten your man of God with your attendance. Any man of God who have the revelation. And what is the revelation? The revelation of who Christ is. Who do men say I am? You are the Son of God. And you are the Christ, the Messiah. If Christ reveals his identity for you, your foundation is solid. Am I talking to somebody here? Your family is built on the rock. Your business is built on the rock. Your education is built on the rock. Your marriage is built on the rock. Anybody can say whatever they want to say. They can think whatever they want to think. But the gate of hell shall not prevail. The gate of gossip shall not prevail. The gate of negative accusation shall not prevail. Because upon this rock, I pity men of God that build their church on personality. I hear men of God asking how many caliber of people are coming to your church. I say that's stupidity. When you are spiritual, you don't ask such questions. Who care how many caliber? We have great people here who are attending. This is not the personality that attend your church is inconsequential. There's one personality that should not miss the church, and is the foundation, the rock of ages. When is the rock? Amakaba. Personalities will come and go. Big men will come and go. Rich men will come and go. They will come and go. Whether they be president, they will soon die. Whether they be governor, they will die one day. But there is a rock that is dieless. He can never die. He's called the eternal rock of ages. The eternal rock of ages. I will build my church. Anytime I come to the church, I don't see myself. That's why you never see me call myself Geo, because I understand the rock is built on the Geo, the one who is the general overseer of all, the eternal rock of ages. I understand that the church is built on the rock of ages.
I want to build a church not on me, a church that will outlive me, that after I leave the earth, the generation of the generation to the generation that is yet on board, there will be fire in their bones. They will be carrying the fire. It will be going a geometric progression. It is not built on Joshua, Igila. This is not a family church. It is a church built on the eternal realm of ages. Am I helping somebody here? I will build my church. I will build your family. I will build your marriage. I will build your life. I will build your destiny. The gate of hell shall not prevail. They can't prevail. They will fight, but they can't prevail. They will try to stand, but they can't prevail. I will build my church. I will build my church. I will build my church. And the gate of hell shall not prevail.
Can I help you here? Sit down. Shabalakata. Am I helping somebody? Am I helping somebody? Before I talk about the caterpillar and pillars in the church, now you must understand that the church is built by God. So it's not built by it's not built by the physical features. Now hear this. The church is not the structure. We have long deceived ourselves. And that's why if there is any army, God is rising up, is a mobile church. Did you hear me now? God is rising up a mobile church. A church that is locomotive in nature. A church that is a living thing. A church that is breathing. A church that does not, that is not around the four corner. So when I hear people talk about church, they think it's this four wall. No! This is not the four wall. When he said, I will build my church, he was saying, yeah, Peter, you are the church I am building to move forward, to go to Ephesus, to go to the Corinthian church, to meet everywhere. I will build you. I will build you. We are not building pillars and big church. We are building entity that makes up the structure. Am I talking to somebody here? You are the church. You are the church. You are the church. Out of your belly shall flow springs of living water. You are the church. You are the church. When I'm in America, the church is in America. When I'm in Soweto, the church is in Soweto. When I'm in the village, the church is in the village. When I'm in the bus, the church is in the bus. When I'm in the aeroplane, the church is in the aeroplane. You are the church. The church is not the structure. The church is not the building. The church is human capacity. Human capacity. Human capacity. Can I talk here? That's why I feel bad when a prophetic church does not teach the word of God. Because the church is not being built. The church is not being built. You can build an expensive church. I'm building an expensive church. So don't think if I say that, I don't know what. You can build an expensive church and the people there are not expensive. You do not hear me? The people there are not expensive. They are empty. No quality and quantity. The worth of any church is not the crowd. It is the quality of people spiritually. Not the amount of people that pack car. Not the amount of rich people. Not the president that attend the church. The quality of member that the man of God produces. Am I talking to somebody here? Don't allow yourself to be deceived. The church is in you. The Bible said, know ye therefore that your body is the temple of the living God. The Lord does not stay just in the structure. He lives in your body. He lives in your body. Let no man henceforth trouble me, for in my body appear the mark of the living God. God. The Bible said your life is hidden in Christ Jesus, and Christ Jesus in God. That if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Behold, all things are passed away. The greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. He's no longer in the tabernacle, he's inside Joshua Igila. He's no longer in the structure, he's inside Joshua Igila. He's no longer dwelling in the wood, he's inside Joshua Igila. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Am I helping you? Some people are looking for God and he's inside. He's inside, he's inside. Greater is he that is in me. If demons can stay in the body of somebody, the Holy Ghost is inside me. If you can look deep inside, you will not go to the wood, you will not go to the four corner. He lives inside you. Know ye therefore that your body is the temple of the living God. Your body is the temple. Your body is the church of the living God. Your body is the temple of the living God.
Sit down, let me help you. I'm laying foundation. I don't know how I can finish this sermon.
So now, you now know that the church is not the four walls, it is you.
So when he said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail, he's saying that I will build the Gila for this end time, and no power can prevail against him. Are you hearing me now? Are you hearing me now? What will move the wall is not this building. It is you.
Can this building talk?
No.
What makes this building okay?
You.
So when we spend time on the building and not spend time on the human capacity, we've lost it. I have seen men of God spend time building wonderful building, but they have not spent time cooking spiritual food to feed the entity that filled the building. The entity that are in the building and the capacity. Now, the Bible says in the great house of God, they are vessel of honor and they are vessel of dishonor. They are vessel of gold and silver and they are vessel of wood. Now I ask, what kind of vessel are you? What kind of vessel are you? What kind of vessel? Are you vessel unto honor or vessel unto dishonor? In the great house of God, there are vessels. There are vessels. They are all vessels. But one carried dishonor. One is called dishonorable and that one is called honorable. So I don't know whether you are the dishonorable or the honorable. And the question is, are you a caterpillar or a pillar? Are you a caterpillar or a pillar? Now the word caterpillar. Most often, the scripture look using it, he's talking about the insect part of it. And it can be two categories. You are either an insect caterpillar or a machine caterpillar. Any part of it. The plant can be eaten up by a caterpillar. And the machine caterpillar, the structure can be pulled down by a caterpillar. And the word caterpillar, I can underline it, getting from counterpillar. Counterpillar. Against the pillar. Am I communicating? Anything that is counterpillar is what? Anything that fights the pillar is caterpillar. So I would love to use the word counterpillar. Anything that counterpillar. Anybody you see around the church that is against the pillar of the church is a caterpillar. And the problem of the church is that the church have not treated the caterpillar. And anytime, Makubayata, anytime there are caterpillars, the church can go up. Nehemiah was building the walls of Jerusalem. Tobias, Sambalant, and the rest of them, they were against Nehemiah. They
looked as if they wanted to support him. The Bible said when the men were building the wall, they had armor in one hand and they were using the other hand to build. Nehemiah was talking here about how they tried to intimidate him, how they tried to introduce phobia, fear into him, how he refused, how they hired a prophet to prophesy lie to him, how they wanted to make him a reproach because he was building the wall.